And she would sometimes talk to me and tell me how she felt so uncomfortable because everyone wanted to serve her, and she does not like to be served. So she was very strongly trying to convince me to tell the devotees to not keep offering her services. Even though she was so sick, it would have been very, very difficult for her to do things by herself. But she never wanted to be in the center. She hated to be served, but she loved to serve. It's their greatest happiness to serve you. You're the closest thing that they've ever seen to personal service to Srila Prabhupada. They may be serving you a little, but by giving them the experience, the happiness, the joy of serving you, you are serving them unlimitedly. She surrendered to let everybody do everything for her. She said, "I surrender." But then the next time I met her, she said, "I surrendered, but still I don't like it." Again, such an example. When we have a senior position and people like to help us or serve us, following in Yamuna Devi's footprints, we should never think that they're serving me. Because our philosophy is servant of the servant of the servant, and that even means to our juniors and the junior most juniors of our juniors. That sometimes, according to our position, by allowing someone to serve me, it's my humble service to them, to encourage and inspire them. Because ultimately they're not serving me, they're serving Srila Prabhupada through me. They're serving Krishna through me. That's the consciousness that she taught. Her love was like every single devotee's personal mother. Her gravity and courage was like a soldier. And her simplicity and purity was like a child. She has done so much to transform so many people's hearts over the decades. Prabhupada said that she had attained bhava, or love of Krishna. There wasn't many people Prabhupada said that about. And being taught cooking by Srila Prabhupada, she wanted to share it with the world. So she wrote a cookbook, Lord Krishna's Cuisine, and it won almost every international award as the cookbook of the year. And she's simply glorifying Krishna through whatever she does.
I do remember very clearly that Srila Prabhupada first gave me the name Kalindi, which is another name of Jamuna. And very quickly, within 10-12 seconds, he said, "No, it is Yamuna Devi." And I said, "What does that mean, Swamiji?" And he said, "The river that Krishna sports in Vrindavan is Jamuna." Srila Prabhupada had such a way of showing a love and affection through distributing Krishna consciousness, that immediately we felt he was the only object of. I'd never known what love was until I met Srila Prabhupada, and I think that was true for all of us. We learned to love each other through Srila Prabhupada, and we had very deep, wonderful, transcendental relationships between each other as God brothers and God sisters, and Srila Prabhupada was the father.
Adi Purusham.